Hello friends, today in this lecture we are going to talk about tumor vaccines. So here we talk about the vaccines that immunize the individuals against tumors. It means that these vaccines helps to train the individual's immune system to recognize and destroy the harmful substances in the body, right? See, there are two types of vaccines. The first type is called prophylactic cancer vaccines, or simply you can call it as cancer preventive vaccines, right? This is the first type. And the second type is therapeutic vaccines, which are also called as cancer treatment vaccines. So first we talk about prophylactic cancer vaccines. So prophylactic cancer vaccines works against virus associated tumors, and these prophylactic cancer vaccines protects the individual from developing certain forms of cancer which are associated with viruses like human papilloma virus and hepatitis B virus. See, if human papilloma virus stays for a very long time in the body, it can cause certain cancers like cervical cancer, vaginal cancer, vulvar cancer and anal cancer. So FDA has approved an human papilloma virus vaccine called Gardasil vaccine, which consists of human papilloma virus strains like 6, 11, 16 and 18, and another HPV vaccine called Cervarix vaccine, which consists of just two strains called 16 and 18 to prevent these cancers. So we need to immunize the young females with these HPV cancer preventive vaccines to prevent the development of cervical cancer, right? This is how we deal with the cancers associated with human papilloma virus. Now, there is a cancer called liver cancer, which is linked to hepatitis B virus. So immunizing against hepatitis B virus with hepatitis B vaccine is going to reduce the levels of liver cancer, right? So this is all about prophylactic vaccines. Now let's move on to cancer treatment vaccines, which is the second type. So in this case, we need to treat a patient that has already developed a tumor, right? So here there's a tumor vaccine called Provenge or Sipuleucel T, which is a prostate cancer vaccine, uses the patient's own cells to develop a vaccine, right? See, these tumor vaccines can target dendritic cells in vivo. Let me tell you the concept of how this tumor vaccine works. See, usually this vaccine comprises of two things. One is it comprises of a tumor antigen, or you can call it as cancer specific antigen. This is one thing. And the second thing is it also consists of an antibody, right? And these two things are in a conjugated state. So the tumor antigen is conjugated with an antibody that is made against a dendritic cell surface molecule, for example DEC-205. So the aim here is that we have a tumor antigen and we use the antibody to take that tumor antigen reach to the dendritic cells, and then the tumor antigen will be taken up by these dendritic cells, processed by these dendritic cells and presented to T cells. This is first part. The second part is we have monocytes or CD34 positive precursors, and these cells can be loaded with the tumor antigens and differentiated into dendritic cells using cytokines such as granulocyte macrophage colony stimulating factor and interleukin-4. So you take patient cells, incubate them with the antigen, make the dendritic cells develop from these blood monocytes, and you then reinfuse these dendritic cells back into the patient. Provenge or Sipuleucel T is approved by the FDA in 2010 for the treatment of asymptomatic or minimally symptomatic metastatic castrate resistant hormone refractory prostate cancer, right? And this vaccine called Sipuleucel T is customized for each person through a series of steps. So in this strategy, on day one, the patient undergoes leukapheresis to isolate precursors of dendritic cells, nothing but white blood cells. So here, in this first step, what we do is, we remove the white blood cells from the person's blood. This is step one, right? In step two, these white blood cells are modified in a laboratory to recognize and target the prostate cancer cells. So here, prostatic acid phosphatase linked to the cytokine GM-CSF is incubated with these isolated blood cells. And over the course of 2 or 3 days, the GM-CSF causes differentiation of these blood leukocytes into dendritic cells. And the prostate acid phosphatase tumor antigen gets delivered via these dendritic cells when infused back into the patient. And T cells within this patient will become activated that are specific for this tumor antigen. And the whole process is repeated at weeks 2 and 4, right? This is all about tumor vaccines. So if you like this lecture, please do share this lecture. And if you are not yet subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel for more interesting concepts. We meet in the next lecture with an interesting concept. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you.